Hello, Sinvicta.
Hello, Northern Lion.
We got Ascended. Sinvicta's hungry.
I am
famished. Or do we play it super slow?
Wow. Surely you wouldn't do that.
Let the cells get completely devoid of all nutrition and energy.
I'd like to call an emergency meeting. I know who the imposter is, please.
Well, without further ado, we can set it. 3, 2, 1, good luck.
Good luck. Have fun. Trying to go into the weekend here with a 2-0 lead. Two-game lead?
Yeah, it would be a two-game lead.
It would be a 2-0 lead. It would be a two-game lead. That'd be nice. I'd much prefer that than going back to Tide. I think NL
that's
May...
it's scary, right? Because like a one game or one goal lead, the next goal, you got a big advantage. They score the next goal, all of your positive feelings are erased.
Travel in comfort. Mosh Turismo.
Yo, great game.
15x daily.
Yeah, I'm looking at that one right now. Modern up country.
Yeah. Not the down country. But it says
how do you get back?
Well, yeah. I mean, you got to go up. You got to go up until you go through the down, I guess. But it said it started in Nairobi, and that's like looking around and I'm thinking it's not colorful enough to be Nairobi.
Yeah, no, I agree with that, actually.
Dreamline. Like, where are all the painted vans? You know?
I couldn't agree more.
There is a lot of painted buses, though. Like, a lot of painted buses.
And you know what? The fact that there's a lot of buses in general.
Yeah.
Kind of makes you think, right?
How many places... Well, I'm gonna start safe, I guess.
I am kind of. This is again a question steeped in ignorance, that I'll admit right off the bat. But there's also like a big mosque.
Yeah, that's the thing that's kind of throwing me off. We didn't really see any of that the last time that or ever when we're in Nairobi. It's usually all Christian stuff.
Yeah. What is this bus? Oh my god. Did you see the Xeno Dreamline?
I did.
With the horrible like griffin.
Yeah.
Decal.
That's the one that had me convinced.
Oh my god. This is terrifying, dude. Baby Shark. Did you see that?
No, I didn't.
I don't, but it was great. The place is called Baby Shark, but the sign looks ancient. It's like it predated the meme. Okay.
You think that is that?
I got some intelligence on this one.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, well, I'm glad for you.
I'm equally happy for you as well.
I'm very glad that you got some intelligence.
I don't have a lot of it, that's for sure.
Hey, ba-dum bum ch. You ever think it's weird that Jerry Seinfeld used his real name for the show Seinfeld, but everybody else was an actor using... a pseudonym?
It comes off. Would I be wrong in saying that it seems a little narcissistic when we're?
I actually I don't like Jerry as a stand-up comedian at all. I think his style is kind of like super dated,
right?
And doesn't fit in the modern world. I do find him to be a funny guy, like in Comedians in Cars and Coffee. I find him to be quite witty, but I definitely also get the impression that he has an ego, and I wouldn't be surprised to find that that's the case.
We tied. I saw the sub hospital, and that's what I was like.
Oh.
It's not Nairobi.
I will say
also not
Jerry's
Nairobi.
Jerry's self inflated or inflated self-image, I should say, has given us great moments, like the time Kesha asked him for a hug at that awards show, and he just put up both of his hands and said, "No, I don't think so." And then she said, "Aw, come on." And he said, "No, I don't think so." And then she said, "Aw," and walked away. I was like, "Yeah, you know what, Jerry? Good for you. It's your right."
Yeah, I mean, if you don't want contact with another human being, you don't have to. Have you ever been to this town and had sushi?
I don't believe, based on the fact that this whole town appears to be constructed around producing, I don't know, wrenches or mufflers or something, I don't believe that this is a high tourist destination, but I could be wrong.
Fire cistern.
I might be mistaken, but
I'm worried about this guess because you are much stronger in Japan without any context really than I am.
I would say if we are in a city, I would definitely give myself an advantage in Japan. In the countryside, I think we're both kind of equally bad.
It just comes down to like just who guesses like the right side of the country, basically.
I think we also both get things right for wrong reasons when this happens. We'll be like, "Well, I saw this, so I put us like, you know, in the south." And you're like, "Well, maybe."
What's she growing over here? What are those?
You know what she's growing.
I see sunflowers.
I see sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. It's from South Park?
No.
How's that in my head?
That's an old... it was on The Simpsons, first off, and secondly, it's an
oldies. Yeah.
It's an oldies song.
That must be where I saw it. Dude, it's a nice BMW convertible there. Somebody's balling up here.
I'm glad somebody is.
So I'm going to hit you with something fairly obvious.
What's that?
No English, like, at all.
Yeah, there's you really get outside of the big cities of Japan and you find a startling lack of English.
Very selfish.
Yeah.
Really.
They should think about us foreigners playing GeoGuessr.
Don't they want the tourism dollars from people who just want to come here and gawk?
I don't want to take a dive. But I have a feeling that this is not right. Let's say we're over here.
I got into this city proper, but...
I did too, but there's nothing that... I mean, I can't read Japanese, so... doesn't help.
Well, me neither. And I also am like, these roads are not big enough, I think, for this to be too likely that I'm going to figure it out.
Actually, that's a dumb guess because there's no mountains around here. So I'm going to say over here and just hope. Oh,
let it ride, boys.
My map froze.
Uh-oh. Oh, my map opened.
Here? Ah, I don't know, man. I just let it ride. Hope for the best. It's not the best. Dang it, I should have stayed over there. I knew that we were near water. Oh,
there's Ogaki.
We were that close to a big city?
Yeah, man. Dude, wow. Nagoya's pretty friggin' huge,
too. We must have been on the super outskirts there. You got me by 600.
Well, it's room to work with, for sure.
What's your score right now?
91.84.
I'm at 85.44.
It's like, it's not salty because I'm up. But it's like clockwork. I have like a guest that puts me ahead, and then they're like, boom, South American desert. Good luck. Miles and miles of nothing around.
But it's not like I have any inside knowledge that I don't understand.
I know Spanish. You're just better at it than I don't know what to do. I wish I did.
Shout out to my Argentinian peeps.
Like, I don't get me wrong. I get that South America's pretty big. There are wide swaths of it that are relatively uninhabited. It shows up to me disproportionately much in a diverse world. But I don't know if there's a little algorithmic tweak for that. Like, I don't know if they're like, oh yeah, make sure you send out extra South American desert guesses. I doubt it.
This one's going to get one of us into trouble. Or possibly both of us.
You think so?
Is that a kid or an old man? I can't tell. Dude, I don't know, man.
I think we're like here. Here-ish?
Peso.
I've got a little intelligence here.
Peso, max poor. He has traseros. Peso, bruto, total 45 tons.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you don't want to mess with that. Or you go in the grinder.
So you got a little intel here.
I got a little intel. Just not much. Not much. Not too much.
I bet we're somewhere. Vermeon. Facing that.
Oh, I got some intel.
This guy says he's got intel.
Do you have any intel?
I see a globetrotter.
Well, you know where we must be then.
Harlem.
Exactly.
Downtown.
You know that one?
Yes.
It's the Harlem Globetrotters.
Yeah.
Theme song.
Right next to the Andy Griffith theme song.
I know that one too. Grandparents used to have a running joke that you can't finish the Andy Griffith song or theme song without while whistling without laughing. And as a kid, I was always like, how did they know? Because I can't do it. Then as an adult, I'm like, it's just because they told you couldn't do it. And then you just believe them. Pretty sure now I could do it no problem.
And I've got these freaking... I've got cities here that I can't find on the map. Just freaking... It was Bolivia. What?
It was Bolivia.
What? I was down near there. I was on the border of Chile and Bolivia near La Paz. And then I found the freaking the city names. I started scrolling north. Well, you got me by 2,800.
I will definitely.
How did you find out that was Bolivia?
You're gonna be mad. You sure you want to know?
Yes.
I saw a car and his license plate said Bolivia.
Oh my god.
And then I was like doing some topographical guesswork and I went a little further and I saw a sign that said La Paz this way. And I went, all right then.
Got a freaking banana leaf on my camera now.
Oh no, dude. I'm not saying you're gonna come back, but I am pretty sure that you are stuck on this road. And you hit a dead end, and then you turn around and you hit a dead end.
I did somehow go in a circle, and I don't know how I did that. Yeah, because there's the dead end.
Little boy, what country is this?
I mean, you know the country.
What are you talking about, dude? You know the country?
100% know the country.
You 100% you know the country.
If I'm wrong about the country, I will forfeit my last guess.
So I've seen a little sign with some text on it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you know what? I think I actually got to a place that has some information. So maybe disregard my previous indignity. Because okay. I for sure thought we were trapped in an area where we could not
move any further.
Yeah. And I was like, literally is just like aluminum houses and trees and dirt. I was like, if this guy knows the country 100%, what the heck happened?
This means you missed something.
Is it Bermuda?
Wow. It is not Bermuda.
But it's not an insult.
Bermuda is not this big.
Okay, that's fair. What a horrible sign I just saw.
You don't see too many open landfields of just, you know, crops and uninhabited jungle in Bermuda.
What on earth is this sign, dude? So it's a big sign, like you would expect it to be placed there by the government, and it just shows a bunch of people kicking the crap out of each other. Like one dude's holding a dude's head while he knees him in the face. Then there's three motorcycles. They have three people on them each, and they're all doing a sick wheelie. What do you think that sign could possibly represent?
I mean, a good time is what I'm.
This is an honest question. Were we in this exact location in the last episode?
I cannot confirm or deny.
Because I'm looking at this sign, and I'm like, dude, I saw this sign. I don't know if it was the same instance of the sign. It was definitely the same iconography.
Okay.
It looks the same. I'm sending it. Dude, that's one. Okay, it's not 100% where we were last time, but it's very close. I got you by 296.
Yeah, this one's pretty much out of reach. Freaking. I don't know how many times I've got in Bolivia at this point.
It does seem to be one of the countries in South America I have a chance on for sure.
All vehicles, no cash.
Oh, we're in America.
Yeah, it gives you the state.
Okay.
So, you know, if you want to play this one out, it's up to you.
I still need to find the state because I don't actually know yet. But yeah, it's a nice truck, dude.
That is the state, isn't it?
I did see a wooden cutout of Bigfoot. Did you see that?
No, I didn't.
Kind of spooked me a little bit.
Was it him?
No, it's just wood.
Okay.
Thankfully. Pretty sure this is good information. Yeah. I see what you're saying now. Do these states border?
It's interstate.
No.
Interstate goes quite far.
Dude, I'm like, what the heck is... Oh, never mind. I found the interstate. Yeah. You're not wrong about that. I didn't know you had this many interstates.
There's a lot of them. I mean, there's a lot of states in the states.
Yeah, but... I mean, is Interstate 376?
Well... There is a lot of them. Just letting you know, there's quite a bit, but normally it stays in the double digit.
So I would imagine that perhaps the three is a sub indicator.
It's more of like a side street. It shouldn't be. It's not like a highway. Let's put it that way.
You know what is a highway?
Life.
Yep.
You're gonna ride it all night long.
Mm-hmm. 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 That's true.
I mean, I've already guessed, so. Feel free to take your time.
We must be in Ohio. Mm-hmm. Because we are on, it says PA Turnpike.
Mm-hmm.
On 376.
Mm-hmm.
376 is gray here.
Mm-hmm.
But where the heck is Leland County? That's the real question.
It's not in Ohio.
So I'm like, okay, I'm like, what the heck, them dude?
I mean, I didn't make the street, so.
Penna Turnpike to Interstate 76.
Mm-hmm.
We gotta be here, dude. It's the only thing that makes friggin' sense. Unless we're down here. You know what I mean? Like in Mogginsville?
Yeah, it's next to the Mohawk Eye Care.
Are we in Mogginsville? Or are we friggin' over here, dude? We're turning right. Should be an eastwards turn. Dude, we're in Ohio. You were trying to trick me. Yeah! I beat you by 500 on that one.
It's not in Ohio, though. It's still Pennsylvania.
Okay, but it's like, look, that part of Pennsylvania wishes it was Ohio, probably.
Well,
you ever think about that?
Good job, Northern Lion. Shout out to your Bolivian peeps out there.
I've tied it up. That one's for all the eggheads out there. We did it, team. I got to say, and again, it's not flexing. It's a 23,000 point day. 23.9.
Yeah.
Is one of my highest scoring weeks ever. So I'm stoked about that at least. But
I didn't even break 20.
Even it up. We will. Oh, no. We will even it up heading into next week just the way we like to see it. For now, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, no matter who you're watching, click the like button. Of course, you can watch both of us with the view sync located on either of our respective channels. For now, thanks for watching. We'll see you on Monday.
See you later.